G'day guys, welcome to JoeGa Fitness. I hope you are doing really well. Today we have got a body conditioning workout for you. It's going to be a little bit of mixed cardio. My aim is, if my memory is working well today, to do one cardio exercise followed by one resistance exercise. And we're going to do them for about 3 minutes. So we're only looking at about 15 exercises, give or take, with the warm up, the cool down, the stretch, possibly only 10. So nice and simple today, just lots and lots and lots of repetitions, just keep it going. If you do enjoy it, as always, please like, share and subscribe and hit the bell to let me know you've been through. Get in touch using the mediums below and I look forward to seeing you again really soon. Start with a little warm up, just roll through the shoulders, bend through the knees, little squatting position, little warm up of the upper body. Just make those shoulder rolls into big arm circles, taking it round and through. Lovely. Just roll through the waist, release through the knees, just wrapping out. And then we'll get going. So lots of time per exercise today. We're not rushing through anything like we would say in a HIIT or a Tabata, even more rushed. Just take a marching position, just shake up through those legs. We're gonna start off, grab your weights straight away, but just remember, warming up to go nice and easy. Little side squat, side to side. Just taking it down and up. Mindful of form, body up nice and tall, heart lifted. Bottom going down, bending through the knees. And just allowing yourself time to go through them. Keep going. Oh dear. It's a bit of a stress for a morning. I've done without that.
Make sure those elbows nice and high, they're flaring out.
So we're not using the biceps, we're not bringing the hands up in that way. This is all about the shoulders. That's where you should be feeling it. Three little muscles in the shoulders, those deltoids. So we're looking for medial delt and posterior delt. So that's the middle and back, just in case you're not sure. Good work. Keep going all the way through. Really simple today. Once you get it going, just locking on and moving through. So our next cardio exercise, the one after this, I do encourage you to put the weights down because we're looking for a bit more speed. We're going to be doing jacks. So half jacks, remember you've got about 3 minutes of work. So to maintain jacks for that long just might be out of your comfort zone. So I'd rather you do half jacks and keep going without break than do full jacks and keep stopping. If you can do full jacks, repping out for the whole time, perfect. All right, let's do one more. Put those down, put them to one side, and straight in. Arms up overhead is going to increase your intensity. If that's too much for you, it's just the legs. Okay, if you can do full jacks all the way through, then that's great too. I'm going to stay here just so it gives me the opportunity to speak, but keep moving. Hey. Pull on through the belly. Lift the body tall, don't slump. Remember, you can choose your own speed. So you don't have to go at this speed. You can go loads faster or loads slower. You do get a lie down after this. We're going to be doing some flies for the chest. So make that your guide for putting the effort in right now. We're about halfway through. Yeah. So every second now is one closer to the end. Keep going, keep going. As I say, don't stop. You can slow down. You can take the arms out. You can take it up. You can make it bigger. You can make it faster. But please keep going. Less than a minute to go. We're really getting towards the end now. Hey. Last 30 seconds. Make a push to the end. Almost there. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Hey. All right, three. Two and one, let it go. Come straight down, no rest in between. The rests are kind of in the transitions. Laying on your back, knees bent, protect your back. Arms up over your chest, not over your face. Pull them over, belly button even. Open wide, straight arms with just a gentle bend at the elbows. So it's not a chest press, we're not bending the arms down. We're taking them out like wings, hence flies. We're flying. Nice work. Give your body time to recover from that, but keeping moving. Obviously, you can use bigger weights than mine. I had a few technical hitches this morning, and I forgot to go get my bigger ones. But having said that, you can do it without weights. So all of these can be done without weights. And if you don't have weights, remember, you can use makeshift weights, canned goods, bottles of milk, anything, as long as it's equal in both sides. Good. Just keep going. Let the arms come down, squeeze them back in. Try and visualize in your mind's eye the muscles that you're working. This is the chest. So think about lengthening through pectoralis and squeezing it back up. So these big fan-like muscles here that cross at the shoulder, come into the sternum. Think about lengthening and squeezing. Really, if you visualize that, you can really start to isolate the dominant muscle. Obviously, you've got other muscles involved. You're moving at the shoulder, the chest muscles cross the shoulder. So working into the anterior delts as well. So kind of finishing off the delt muscles. We started with the upright rows. Maybe a little bit of biceps in there as well. Bit of tries maybe. Just try and work into that chest muscle. Okay. Three, two, one. Up you come. We have got our cardio. This is going to be a knee lift. So you've got knee lift up in front. Remember, you've got a long time, 3 minutes. So set your pace, set your height, and just keep moving. So you can go much quicker if that's for you, and you can also go much slower. You can go less high. You don't need to have the hands. So really, really personal. Even though it's a group exercise class, you really make it your own. Use your core to lift the knee. So pull your belly button in. Really use your core. And march through. Make sure you're not dipping through your back. Nice and straight and rigid in the spine. Lift the knee up in front rather than this, crunching over. Really pull up tall. Shoulders over hips, over ankles. Yeah. if you're thinking about giving up and going for a drink, just maybe push through. Finish it off. We're coming back with a deadlift bent over row. Can you get my words out there? Okay, let that go. So grab your weights, wipe down water if you need to in between, and I'll show you through. Deadlift to row to upright. So the arms stay straight, they bend into the chest, they go back to straight, and the body moves. Long spine, push the butt out. Soft bend in the knees, but not massive. The legs don't move. Looking for hamstrings here, as well as back. Squeeze into that back. Rhomboids, lats, down. Squeeze left, and rise. Slow you go. For the meantime, keep with these. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Squeeze and rise. Last one. Take a wipe and a drink. Coming back to skaters. Weights down. Ooh. Okay. Soon as you can, in. So option is just to do a bowler lunge, step, bowl, step, bowl. If you can do skaters, it's that little bit of propulsion into that jump. Into those legs, real curtsy. So getting those muscles working. Otherwise, imagine there's a, in fact, you could even put your weights in the middle of the mat. Imagine there's something there that you're jumping over. Just getting that little bit of propulsion going on. Being mindful, of course, of your knees. I know there are quite a few of us that have knee issues. So mindful of how it feels. And obviously if you've got ankle, hip issues, backs, then you've got to be careful of those too. Hey. So I don't know if you can see, but I've managed to put my towel down over the timer, so I've no idea how long we've been going. Here we go. How long we've got to go. It's silly. Less than a minute. That's good, isn't it? When you look down, you're into those final few seconds. Here, protect your back. Of course, it can be done without weights. It can, of course, be done with much heavier weights. It can be done slower and it can be done faster. This is only ever a guide. Keep your back long, don't drop your back. Bum going behind you, not dropping my chest. Long through the spine. Bum down, up, down, release. Whee! Keep going. Let's do two more. Last one. We've got plank jacks. I want to just show you some alternatives. So, if you're on your knees, you can touch to the side if this is your level. If you can do full plank, full jacks, this is your level, or you can tap these as well. So, if you can't come up on your wrists, you can do it on your elbows.
or you can jack, or you can do it off the knees. So there really is, again, hopefully, unless you've got really, really dodgy shoulders, no excuse for not doing, okay? So, just find your rhythm. Tapping out, my plank is rubbish, it's more of a pike. You can do that as well. If you need to, bum up, piking out. Oh, mate. Keep going the best you can. Hold it in plank if you can't do the moves. Or you can do mountain climbers if you're really struggling. Hey. Into the last 30 seconds or so.
nearly there. Okay, last one. Coming back up, we've got pushbacks. Weights down. So, arms come up, push back with the leg. Swing the arms up. It's gonna be our last cardio. So use that to help you get through. Remember, no arms is an option. Excuse me. Dry throat. It's quite warm again. Which is lovely, but it makes your workouts a bit tricky. Point. Nearly there. Over halfway. Coming down towards that last minute. We've got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Well done. Come on down. Oh. Reach the arms away. Crunch up right and left. Twisting the body, not just throwing the arms. It's not just this where you move the arms. You've got to lift and crunch round the corner. Again, there is absolutely a choice to lift the legs into tabletop. And this time I will say you can lift one if you want to keep alternating. That is going to make it a little bit more cardio than strength. If you want to keep your weights, you can. I don't like to use weights too much on ab exercises. You don't want a thick waist. You don't want to be building muscle there. You want a nice lean trim waist, but you want it to be nice and strong. So I don't tend to add weights into abs. Your elbows, so bend your hands under your head. crunch laterally, as if you're trying to bring the same elbow as leg down to touch the ankle. So right to right, left to left. Just an option. Let it go. Just rock your head from side to side. Make sure your neck feels released. And then just really reach through. So I am aware that we started late because of my technical issues. So if you do need to go off, if you've got work, then just carry on. Have a great day. If you can hang around for a minute or two more, I'm going to run through a stretch. So it's up to you. Draw the knees in, gently rock the back. And bring yourself up and over. Come onto all fours, just a little cat-cow in position. Just a little stretch. Take it back into child's pose, reach the arms forwards. If your knees don't like this, then stay on your back, go back over onto your back, hug your knees in. Walk your hands around to one side, stretch the side of the body. And going straight over to the other side to stretch the other side. And then coming up. Whew. Take the arms open, around behind, looking for a chest stretch. And then round in front, back stretch. Really scoop the belly in, round off through the shoulder blades, open for traction. One arm up and over, calf stretch. Same leg forwards, hamstring stretch. You can stretch your hands if you want. And then change sides. If you find double stretches a bit too complicated or a bit unstable, separate them out. Excuse me. Okay, one arm coming across, drop the shoulder down, and we're gonna sink over to stretch the inside thigh. And then roll it the other way. Good, turn around, calf stretch. Take it out, biceps. And then swivel round. Other calf, other bi. Scoot that leg in, sit down. Looking for soleus. Gastroc, this big one here, soleus down into Achilles. And just step that forwards. Doing the other side. Lovely. Take the legs wide, reach down, lift up, reach over, and release. Down, up, and over. Beautiful. Bring the legs together, sitting down, reaching up, bring it through to heart, take it out wide. And give yourselves a round of applause. Well done, everybody. Thank you so much.